Kerry Gaj. I'm a medical science liaison for the Natera Organ Health Team. I'm here today to detail to you a poster titled Utility of Genetic Testing in Informing Management of Patients with Kidney Disease. This is a poster that was accepted for presentation at the American Society of Nephrology's Kidney Week in November of 2021. This poster was a collaboration between Dr. Gina Ross, Dr. Kinar Javeri, and Dr. Deepa Malikiel from Northwell, and also Laurel Kochner, Dinah Clark, and myself from Natera. You can see here in its entirety the poster that was presented at ASN's Kidney Week. I will, in the next couple of slides, walk you through each one of these individual sections, including the results from this particular center investigation. So let's get started with some background. Early identification of monogenic causes of chronic kidney disease through genetic testing can improve disease treatment, can inform on management, and can also improve patient outcomes. Genetic testing can be useful for families with a history of CKD in planning for the future, including appropriate identification of patients that may be donors for potential kidney transplant recipients. In this abstract, we describe the use of genetic testing with the Renasight panel. The Renasight panel is a next-generation sequencing, large gene panel with over 380 genes for kidney disease. And in this clinical experience, we will assess the ability of the Renasight panel to inform treatment for patients being treated for different kidney abnormalities. Describing the methods of this examination, this was a retrospective analysis of genetic results that were done at a large academic center over an 18-month period using the Renasight panel. After signed informed consent was completed, broad genetic testing was performed on blood or saliva samples for 31 patients. Genetic testing results were then related to alterations in management of treatment of these patients. You can see down in figure one, this is the Renasight workflow that was applied at the center. Patients with chronic kidney disease, electrolyte disorders, nephrothiasis were screened. They were signed consent. A Renasight sample was obtained from a blood or saliva sample. It was shipped to the Natera lab to undergo next-generation sequencing and analysis of the 380 genes contained on the panel. Of note, the detection rate of the Renasight panel is over 99% across all the genes that were screened. Lastly, test results were available and reported back to the center within 3 to 4 weeks. To describe the results of this center experience, this particular cohort was 41.9% female and was average aged of 51 years. The most common demographic group in this center experience were African American and also Caucasian. There is about 20% of those each. The most common indication for performing genetic testing with Renasight was CKD, and 19 of the 31 patients examined were noted to have CKD. Positive results were identified in 13% or 4 of the patients. And those genes that were identified were COL11A1, COL4A4, and APOL01. Genetic testing results led to a change in management for over 35% of patients, confirmed diagnosis for over 22.5% of patients, provided additional diagnoses for almost 50% of the patients, and prompted additional family testing for about 23% of those patients. Table 1 on the right details those indications for performing genetic testing. Table 2 details the positive findings from the gene testing, as well as the number of cases involved. Additional results included the impacts to patient management. 4 individuals with positive findings had transplant management that was impacted, had a biopsy performed to confirm Alport syndrome, biopsy performed to confirm FSGS diagnosis, and also initiation of dialysis. Those patients that had negative results also had changes and alterations in management, with almost 50% of them having some sort of change in management. To conclude the findings of this abstract, in this particular cohort at an academic practice, genetic testing informed nephrologists' management of their patients in multiple capacities. Negative results can rule out genetic causes of diseases, and carriers and variants of unknown significance, or VUSs, can inform planning for families and also enable an additional testing for family members. This concludes today's abstract review of the utility of genetic testing in informing management of patients with kidney disease. Any additional questions or comments can be directed to myself, Kerry Gaj. My email is provided here, kgaj@natera.com. Also, please feel free to visit the Natera website for additional information regarding Renasight testing. Thank you for your time and have a great day.